Hello student, welcome back to our computer class. Today we are going to learn a new lesson, that is lesson number 3, working of a computer. In previous lesson we have seen what is computer, that computer is an electronic machine. It works on electricity. Yes, all this we have learned. Then we also have learned about the parts of computer. What are the different parts of computer? Monitor, CPU, keyboard, mouse and printer. We also see the use of this different parts of computer. Today we are going to learn about how they are going to be work. How the different parts of computer are going to be work together. Okay, so in this chapter we are learning the working, the different parts of computer will work together. That's why this lesson number 3 is working of a computer. How they are going combining the parts, how they are going to be work. A computer cannot work on its own. Whenever you open the computer, we have to first switch on electricity, then click on the start button. Okay, then only the computer will open. Computer can do this it's on its own, no, no. For that, for opening the computer, we have to open the computer. Computer cannot do its own. The same way, whenever your work is finished on the computer, okay, whether it is writing work, listening work, reading work, okay, and when you want to close the computer or switch off the computer, you click on shutdown button. After shutdown, after clicking on shutdown, the computer will close or get switched off. Okay, so all this thing can computer do its own? No, no. We have to perform all this function on a computer. Got it? This means computer cannot do its work on its own. Then you need to enter letters, number and instruction into the computer to work on it. This is called data. So whatever the letter, sentence or words you write on a computer, or a numbers or the symbols, okay, like addition, multiplication, division, these types of data, okay. So all these are nothing but the instructions. Whatever the instructions you give to the computer, computer will work on that instruction. Okay, computer will work on this instruction. This is called data. This is called data. Whatever you write on a computer, this you are writing letters or number, these are nothing but the instruction. This instruction is given to the computer and computer will work on this instruction. On this instruction computer will work, it's called a data. Okay, it's called data. Got it till this? Now the next. Computer works on three basic steps. Now the computer will work on three basic steps, that is input, process and output. Okay, now we are going to see these three basic steps one by one. Before we go the actual how the computer will work in input, process and output, we will see some example. Here are some example, like blunt pencil is our input. Okay, after our nip of a pencil will broken, this blunt pencil is our input. Where we will put this pencil? We will put in a sharpener and sharpen that pencil. So sharpener become a process. And after sharpening, we will get the sharp pencil. So sharp pencil is our output. Like this also, like this our computer will work, input, process and then output. We will see one more example. Okay, the next example is of dirty clothes. Okay, so here after playing, okay, after some work our clothes get dirty. So our dirty clothes is input. After this, where you will keep this dirty clothes? You will put all these dirty clothes in washing machine. For what?
to make it clean. Okay, after dumping all these dirty clothes in a washing machine, what will a washing machine do? Washing machine will start its process. Okay, what will it do? It will mix all these dirty clothes. You have put some powders and waters. Okay, washing powders and waters, and washing machine will mix all this thing, waters, powder, washing powders, and this dirty clothes will get mixed to get a clean cloth. Okay, so this is nothing but the process. And after your this process is over, okay, what will you do? You will take out your clean cloth from washing machine and you can put it out so that your clothes will get dry. Okay, so after take outing this cloth from washing machine, you will put your cloth for drying. Okay, so this is nothing and you will get the clean cloth. This is a output. Okay, this is a output. So here dirty cloth become input. You are putting this dirty clothes in washing machine is a processor. Washing machine will do, it will clean your dirty clothes. So it is a process, and after cleaning you will get the washing machine process is over, you will get the clean cloth. This is nothing but the output of the process. Okay, like this computer is also do. Okay, we will see next. Now
let's take an example of your body. When your teacher asks you a question, you hear with your ear and see with your eyes. Okay, so that hearing, that hear with your ear and see with your eyes, it become ear and eyes become a input device for you. Okay, it is a input unit for you, your eyes and your ear. Okay, after asking that question, your brain, which has stored some information early, it start thinking. Okay, so thinking process will start. So whatever the question your teacher ask you, your process quick response and your brain will start thinking on it. And after that your brain will give you permission to speak. Okay, it will give you permission to speak and tell the answer. So your brain here become a process. What will it do? It will think over that question and tell you, now you know the answer of this question, you can tell the teacher. Okay, so the brain will become a process, and when you start telling the answer to the teacher, that is nothing but the output. You are telling the answer to your teacher is nothing but the output. So in this way your eyes and ear become input, your brain become process, and you tell your teacher with your mouth, it's become a output. By using these things, by using all this input, process and output, the actual work will done by the you, by your body. Okay, got it? The same way will computer will do. Now we will see that. Input: when you enter the data and instruction into the computer, it is called input. Input data through a keyboard and a mouse. So tell me, while you are in front of a computer, where you will type? On a keyboard. Through a keyboard you will start typing and it will display on a computer. So whatever the data you will type, that is number, letters, symbols, okay, whatever data you will type, and with the mouse, with the help of mouse, you move the cursor. So this, with the help of this keyboard and mouse, whatever the data you entered, data and instruction you entered into the computer, is called input. That's why this keyboard and mouse is called a input device, because we are giving the data to the computer through this keyboard and mouse. These are the keyboards, all of you know, you have seen in your school, and this is small little tiny mouse.
Now the next is process. Working on the data is called processing. The CPU acts on the data to solve problems and give the correct result. Okay, whatever the data or instruction you entered in a computer, this CPU will process on that data and gives you a correct result. For example, if you have entered two numbers, 2 plus 3, okay, and you want to do a addition of that two number, what will happen? After you have entered this data, this CPU will process. It will see, oh, it is a number and it has a symbol of plus. Okay, addition, it is a symbol of addition. So what will it do? It will add that two number, that is 2 plus 3, it will become 5. Okay, and this CPU will give you the correct result. Okay, this way your CPU will work. And your CPU will process on the given data and instruction from the computer. Got it now? Now we will see next. This is your CPU. All of you know a CPU? That big box? Yes. Output. Now, after getting input from computer, who will give the input? Keyboard and mouse. With the help of keyboard and mouse, you will type, okay, so it is become a input. After getting input to a computer, computer will give it to the CPU and CPU will process on that and give you the correct result. That correct result is nothing but the output. Okay, so now we will see, you know, we have seen the example of addition. Okay, two numbers, 2 plus 3, and after process would become 5. That 5 is nothing but your output. Okay, so output, it means the final result. So 5 is your final result. You get the answer 5, 2 plus 3 5. This is your final results. It means the final result. When the process is finished, you get the result, which is called output. Monitor and printer are the most common output device. After getting you the output, okay, where it will be display? Yes, it will be display on monitor. Okay, so that your 5 answer, where it will be display? It will display on a monitor. And if you want to take a printout of that, okay, if you want to take a printout of that, with whose help you will print that? With the help of printer. Okay, so monitor and printer are become the output device. In this way, your computer, your actual computer will work. It will take input from keyboard and mouse. After taking input, CPU will process, and after processing, it will display on the monitor. And if you want the printout of that, the printer will give you, okay, the output. So in this way, your monitor, keyboard, mouse, CPU and printer will work. Got it now? How these parts are get connected to each other, connected to each other, and how they will process? Okay. So this is a monitor where the result will display. The result, that is answer, is 5. Then the two number we have seen, that 2 plus 3 equals to 5. So that output will display on the monitors and the printer, where the data will print. Okay, where the output will print. Got it? Now, so in this lesson we have learned about computer, that computer cannot work its own, and whatever the we enter through a letter, number, instruction we entered in the computer, it's called data. We also seen the three basic steps, that is input. We get input through keyboard and mouse. We enter any instruction, and data we written in a computer is called input. Process, CPU will do this process. Whatever the data information it get from computer, the CPU will process on it. And output, this CPU is processing on the data, it will give you output, and this output will display on a monitor or on the form of
print on a printer. Got it up till this? What is computer? How computer is working with these three basic steps, that is input, process and output. Okay, now we are going to see you in a next class with a new chapter. Okay, till then you have to revise all this thing whatever I have taught you today. Okay, now we are going to see in next class. Till then, take care.